Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe You Know Man, welcome to our reaction to Meatloaf. We are going to react to the song, I Would Do Anything for Love. This is requested by our patron Joseph. Let's get started with our reaction to I Would Do Anything for Love.
It is Kirti's first time listen and reaction to this song. Mm-hmm. I have heard this song a few times in the past. So it's definitely not my first time listening to it. Mm-hmm. Meatloaf passed away recently.
Yeah.
And this is I'm assuming it's a tribute request by Joseph for Meatloaf.
Okay.
May his soul rest in peace. And let's see what Kirti thinks of the song.
Yeah. turn around.
I won't do that. No, I won't do that. Anything for love, but I won't do
that.
Wow. Wow. Beautiful.
Powerful. Powerful. Performance.
Oh, who was the lady singing along with him? She is not listed here.
Their voices were so close, I was confused at one point. Are both the sides sung by Meatloaf himself?
No, it can't be.
But sounded, did you not get confused?
No, I was not confused at all. It was someone else. Anyway, what are your thoughts on the whole thing?
I like the vocal performance each time that we react to Meatloaf. Nowadays, it's not that often as it used to be before. His vocals are something. When he's into those, into the recording or into the music session, it's just him and his character and the whole passion that comes along, the power, the energy that he puts into the song. It's literally like a play that you're watching. Of course, they are always ballads. Most of the time that we have reacted to a ballad-like thing. And you're watching like a play happening in front of you, two characters mainly, and, exchanging their conversation with each other. I like this. There was, until the end, I didn't know what he was talking about. I won't do that. I won't do that. At the end, I realized, okay, this is what he won't do. Even though the other side came, I thought it was him trying to do that too. So, forgive me if it was, another artist that was contributing to that. Please forgive me for not getting it on the first listen. Yeah. But I enjoyed this one. It was powerful, to say the least.
What do you think it was all about? There was so much in there initially. Is he talking to a statue? Is he talking to a nun or a spiritual, someone spiritual? Is he talking to a doll, Barbie doll? Is it a real woman?
I think it was a real character. He was just saying he would do anything because he's found this person and he's not going to do all of these things that he is, sharing. Everything that he's sharing with this person. They are so special, he's not going to do that with anyone else. And he's going to be true, he's going to be faithful. Now, also this character that, started telling the lines later on, which was, one-sided and then suddenly the other side comes in. She's telling him she needs to get out of the town and things like that. So I don't know if it is a forbidden love or it is she's already in a relationship with somebody else or she's married to somebody else and he's, trying to convince her, let's get out of here. Maybe her marriage is an abused one or something like that. So the other character of the song seems to be in a, kind of a messy position and he is trying to convince her, let's make it better for you and for me.
Yeah, something and she like also that. Asks if he will fulfill all my fantasies.
I know.
Will you make
yeah,
them
so it's a person who's really
unhappy. Or will you start screwing around? So basically, it seems like he's making a promise to be faithful.
Yeah.
No matter what, he will do anything for love, but he will not screw around. He will not
That's
be
what
unfaithful.
He will not do.
He will not be unfaithful.
Yeah.
I thought when I first heard this song years ago, not just today, I thought it was maybe it's a a relationship with someone who's devoted to a particular cause, to someone else. Maybe it's a nun or sister. Maybe it's a married woman. But I thought maybe a nun, firstly.
Okay.
But it could be a princess, queen, something which is, and this person is maybe a butler or a servant to her, like
could
a slave
be.
To her.
Could be. The relationship is not that
long,
accepted,
long ago,
I think,
So it's someone, a layman, an ordinary citizen of that village or town, and he is having an affair with this queen or princess.
It could
so,
be.
It's murky, it's messy, it's controversial, it's blasphemy maybe. So
blasphemy.
Meatloaf. I would do anything for love. But above all, whatever it is, it is a music that, piano-like sound which was there.
I like how the music plays.
It's like a fairground kind of music.
Mm-hmm.
And then this beautiful voice of Meatloaf, powerful, resounding, voice which is like as if you play it loud and it's like going to be echoing all over your home, That kind of a voice he's got in this one. I don't know how it was done, whether it's just sung naturally in the studio or they played around with the musical arrangement in a manner that was done so technically and so scientifically that it made it sound like the voice was being sung in an arena. Mm-hmm. You know, so that kind of effect was beautiful. I remember years ago, I had this Kenwood system at home. And on this Kenwood music system, you had these preset equalizers. In those days, I'm talking about 20, 30 years ago. These things were new. You know, so it had this arena effect. So when you put it on this arena effect, you know, it would sound like you're in a huge, huge stadium and the band or the artist is performing live, you know, while you're listening to it. So this sounds as if it's already got the arena effect inbuilt into it, you know, if you get my drift. So it's beautifully arranged, beautifully sung. May his soul rest in peace. What a great contribution he made to the world of Western music, rock music, especially rock and roll.
Yeah.
What a great contribution. It may have been have been 30 to 50 songs. I'm not really sure how many songs totally. Mm-hmm. But I don't think it's more than 50, because we would have got, with the kind of caliber of music,
mm-hmm.
We wouldn't be getting less than 10 requests if he had a huge portfolio. So I'm mm-hmm. assuming he has just few songs. But those songs have made a mark for sure. Like this one.
Appreciate the quality over quantity of musicians. Those who keep on producing but they don't have a consistency with the quality. I do not really like those musicians, because beyond a point, when they are not around, those songs really put their reputation down. Because if they are played or requested by others, just to show, oh yeah, this side as well. That is when it goes against the artist. So when you maintain the consistency of the quality while you are around, even after you're gone, people understand that quality was always maintained. And when Savi is talking about the arena feel, I think he himself, not only himself, but he made others around also feel the arena music, the neighbors and everybody. This was, I think, before the marriage. Everyone in the neighborhood knew Savio's collection of music. And some people definitely did not like it to be that loud, but they appreciated the choices. They did appreciate your numbers, the selection.
Yeah,
that you had.
I mean, when I would walk down the road, or you know, I wouldn't know the people, but they knew me.
They knew me,
and I'm assuming it's because of my music collection.
Yeah, they knew you.
So it was really, really popular. Of course, gone are those days now.
I know.
Now I listen to a lot of music, but not that loud. Not that loud.
Yeah.
Not that loud. No, not even in headphones. So even if I listen at home,
it's not as loud. Yeah, it's
and I don't even have a great music system like I did back then.
Not the Kenwood.
It's a normal music system from India. That's it for this one. Goodbye.